out the corner of my eye, I saw a pretty little thing approaching me. She said, I never seen a man who looks so all alone. Could you use a little company? If you pay the right price, your evening will be nice and you can go and send me on my way. I said, you're such a sweet young thing, why you do this to yourself? She looked at me and this is what she said. Oh, there ain't no rest for the wicked. Money don't grow on trees. I got bills to pay, I got mouths to feed. There ain't nothing in this world for free. I know I can't slow down, I can't hold back. Though you know I wish I could. I know there ain't no rest for the wicked until we close our eyes.
How you feeling there, Brian?
I'm fat and out of shape, and my calves hurt, and I'm hot.
You know how far we walked?
Probably like 500 meters.
If that. About a quarter of a mile. Yeah, you warm up quick, don't you?
Yeah. Well,
we have Brian here, and then we have
Chase. Why does my name sound so ominous and gloomy?
Because I have a feeling I'm going to be burying you by the end of this trip. So this whole area is an ancient fossilized reef bed. This whole area used to be one gigantic sea back during the, I believe it was the Permian era, about 400 million years ago. And obviously it dried up, it fossilized, but what happened was it got covered by looser, lighter sediments, basic sediment. And over time, it uplifted due to fractures in the tectonic plates. It's like if you squeeze a potato chip on the sides, uh-huh. It's gonna crack in the middle. That's kind of what happened. That's how you get these mountain ranges that are nowhere near the fault lines, like over by San Andreas in California. Uh-huh. That's where the subduction and stuff happens. But here it's just that cracking in the plate. And then after that, you just have more wind erosion clearing off the lighter, looser sediments that piled on top of the fossilized reef bed. So that's why you have a lot of this limestone and a little bit of granite.
I don't know how those little hobbits did it.
How they made it to Mordor all by themselves, eh? But they had a guide. They had Gollum.
They had what?
They had Gollum.
Yeah.
Smeagol. Don't know if you can see it from there, but that rock has a lot of formica and stuff in it. You can see it's shining. Uh-huh. I don't know if you'd be able to see it in the camera. Looks like got some marble and stuff in there too. And all these different types of sediments embedded in it. Pretty cool. But you could find all kinds of fossils in here if you really took the time to look. And that's quartz up in here. Brian went ahead and downgraded.
Straight
much more comfortable.
Yeah. I was down to my skivvies on a mountain.
Right.
Pretty exhilarating.
Glad a little mountain lion didn't pop out.
Oh, that was sucked.
Yeah.
Probably have more fur on my chest than did on this whole body.
Yeah.
And
then
like, rah!
Dun, 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 dun. I think we will. Eventually, once we get
back in the back.
Yep, up in the hot country. It's a nice little cliff face right here, though.
This is pretty kick ass.
Yeah. Don't fall, Brian!
Don't even. Now I got nervous as soon as you said that, damn it.
You're the one who climbed up there.
I know, but I wasn't nervous until you said anything.
What was that?
Couch potato, college student to mountain man.
Please don't do that. You're gonna scare the children. Oh, this is a ponderosa pine. Pinus ponderosa in the Pinaceae family.
Let's see if I can push this over.
Not a good idea.
But what if it actually worked? I'd be like, oh fuck.
Yeah. Rock. And then right over here next to it.
See? If we had my webbing, we could have tied it off up here somewhere and used it to hold on to.
This right next to it is a pinyon pine, Pinus sedulis.
So where do they make Christmas trees? What kind of pine trees are those?
No, they use, for Christmas trees, they usually use firs and spruces.
Oh, so they're not even pine trees?
No, no. But the pinyon pine, Pinus sedulis, is where you get the pine nuts, uh-huh. Like in a grocery store.
Okay.
They have very tasty pine nuts.
Is that more like, I wouldn't call it a canyon, but that washout right there?
Yeah.
That's just whenever they get bad rain?
Yeah, that's a little...
Do you think there's any river or anything? Like?
A little wadi. No, it's probably intermittent, I would think.
So if it rains a shit ton tonight, which doesn't look like it would.
No, I don't think it's going to rain tonight.
I like how it makes this little bowl.
Good stuff. Cupressaceae. Huh?
Oh.
You're like, where did he go? It's a little bit windy up here.
But it jumped out and got me.
And?
What?
I think we are past the majority of the switchbacks. We are on the other side of the slopes. Looks like we found a fossil. Some wood, it looks like. Not sure if that's exactly what it is, but possibility, I guess.
Could be.
Yeah.
Sounds like wood.
Really, dude?
Yeah, listen.
It's not wood, though.
Whatever.
It's sediment. What happens is microscopic compounds infiltrate the cells of the organic material and replace it. That's how fossils are formed. That's one way fossils are formed. By changing the internal chemistry of the cellular structure.
I'm not good at science.
Oh.
I should be.
I like science. What you eating there?
A spiced pumpkin pie Clif Bar. Nutrition for sustained energy.
Oh.
That's pretty damn good.
Nice. I am eating an iced gingerbread. That's not bad either. I love how Clif Bar comes out with all these seasonal flavors and stuff.
I was kind of excited.
I don't know. Good energy food. Well, distance-wise, I think we're a little over halfway.
Well, we went out for 2 hours and 8 minutes and 40 seconds.
Yeah. Not too bad. Started getting up into some bigger trees. Got some more pinyon pine, a couple ponderosas, and started getting into firs. There's little gray oaks, Quercus graecii or graecii or something like that. Can't remember how you pronounce it. Cool little bridge. So is this easier or harder than you thought it was going to be?
Harder.
Yeah.
Harder for sure.
Yeah.
Like I said before, I'm from the coast. An anthill is elevation.
There is the top of Texas. Dedicated to the airmen who, like the stage drivers before them, challenged the elements through this pass with the pioneer spirit and courage, which resulted in a vast system of airline transport known as American Airlines. Huh. Pretty cool. And here's the box. How you feel, bro?
Fucking lightheaded, out of breath, tired. So we'll take a nap here.